Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Another method for the ensemble of classifiers is boosting. Boosting is a method for building a combination of classifiers. In boosting, similar to bagging, we have one type of classifier. Okay, we only have one type of classifier. And in this type of combination of classifiers, we have two weights: the weight of data and the weight of votes. Okay, these are two parameters that are in this learning model. Weight, the data have weights. Okay, each instance in the training data, they have a weight. Also, the classifiers have weights. Each classifier, for example, if we have five classifier, each of these classifiers, they have a weight. Their weight is it has effect on their vote. Okay, their weight has effect on their vote. In this boosting, weight means importance of the data, importance of the votes of the classifiers. Okay, in the boosting, when a data is wrongly classified, it will get more weight in the next iteration. This is very important in the boosting algorithm, that when a data is classified wrongly, it will get more weight in the next iteration of the training. And the final prediction is the weighted majority vote. Okay, so I will talk about these concepts in the next slide: the weight of the data, the weight of the votes, and the weighted majority vote. Okay, first, the training. Well, when we want to build the boosting, it means we want to build an ensemble of classifiers using the boosting algorithm. Okay, again, we have a loop, and in this loop, we are going from 1 to L, and we want to create L classifiers. And these classifiers that are built, the weight of the data is important. The weight of the data has effect on the classifier. Okay, we have a classifier which could use the weight of a data. That's very important. Not all classifiers could have weight for data. As I said, the weight means the importance. Okay, so we have to, in this boosting, we need a classifier that could use the weight of data. Okay, so we learn a classifier using the data that has some weights. After that, we update the weights of data, and we update the weights of the classifier. Okay, we update the weights of the data and we update the weights of the classifier. Okay, so as I said, we have some weight for the data and we have some weight for the classifier. What do I mean by this? What do I mean? We will see this in the next slides. The weight of the data and the weight of the classifier. And in the test phase, again, each data is given to all of the classifiers in the ensemble. And then the final prediction of this classifier is calculated using the weighted majority vote. Okay, we use the weighted majority vote. Okay, in this figure, we could see the boosting algorithm. As you see in the boosting algorithm, assume this is the data. Each of these is the data. These are the data. And the size of each box means the weight of that data. For example, here we have four data. Okay. At the start of the boosting algorithm, the weight of all of the data are the same. The weight of all the data is the same. All data have the same weights. This is the start situation. And here, okay, using this data, we build a classifier, H1. H1 is the classifier which is built using this data. Okay? So we train a classifier H1 on this data. And then we test the classifier and we see that in this classifier, this data has the correct prediction. This data has a wrong prediction. This data has a wrong prediction. This data has a correct prediction. Okay, so two of the data, their prediction is wrong, and two of them have the correct prediction. Okay, this is the first iteration of the loop in boosting. Now we go to the second iteration. This is the second iteration, okay? This is the second iteration. As you see, in the second iteration, the weight of the data has changed. The data that has been predicted wrongly, it has more weights in this iteration. For example, this data, it has more weight. And this data, the weight is less. Because in the previous step, this data is predicted correctly. Okay, so the data which is predicted wrong, it has more weight. And the data which is predicted correctly, it has less weight. And the sum of the weights is the same. So we are normalizing. Okay, we are normalizing. And the sum of the weights are the same. And then, okay, this is the weights of the data. And then we build classifier H2. Okay, using this data that it has weights. And then we repeat this in the next step again. The weights are changed. And the next classifier is built. Again, this happens. The next classifier is built. So we have four classifiers, H1, H2, H3, H4. We have four classifiers. Okay, each of these classifiers, they have, okay, you see that, so we see that the data has weights. This is one of the weights. The second weight is the weight of the classifier. Classifier H1, H2, H3, H4. Each of these classifiers, they have a weight. each of the classifiers, they have weights. Okay? Now, how do we calculate the weight of the classifier? Okay, we said that the weight of the data is calculated based on this issue, that is the data having the wrong prediction? If we have a wrong prediction for the data, we increase the weight of that data. Now, this is how we calculate the weight of the data. Now, for the weight of the classifier, H1, H2, H3, H4, how do we calculate the weight of the classifiers? Classifier H1, if we want to calculate the weight of H1, what do we do? Okay, we find a classifier we find a classifier and we find the error of the classifier and the test data. The error of the classifier and the test data is used to specify the weight of the classifier. Classifier H1 has a higher weight if the error of the classifier and the test data is lower. So the weight is something opposite the error and the test data. Okay? We calculate the error and the test data, and the weight is the opposite of the error and the test data. So that's how we calculate the weight of the classifiers in the boosting algorithm. Okay, now this is AdaBoost. AdaBoost is an algorithm for it is a type of boosting. AdaBoost is a type of boosting. Okay, let's review this AdaBoost. Okay, this is the data X1, T1. T1 is the label of data 1 and TN is the label of data N. Ti is minus 1 or plus 1. It means that our data has two classes, minus 1, plus 1. Okay. It says that initially assign a uniform weight to all of the data. So in the first step, all of the data, they have the same weight. The first step. All of the data have the same weight. And then we enter this loop. In the loop, we train a classifier HK using the weights. These are the weights. So we should have a classifier that could use these weights of the data. Okay. After that, we evaluate the error of this classifier. We evaluate the error. Epsilon k is the error of this classifier HK. Epsilon k is equal to sigma summation WKI. This is the weight of data I. HKX are not equal to TI. I is a function which has two results, 1 or 0. If HKXI is not equal to TI, HKXI is the prediction of the classifier HK for the data XI. If this prediction is not equal to Ti, this is an error. And this function I, it returns a number 1. And if this condition is not true, the function I returns 0. So this epsilon k is finding the sum of errors, and the weight is multiplied 2. Okay, this is done. And then after we have calculated epsilon k, which is the error of classifier k, we get the weight of the classifier using alpha k based on the error. As I told you in the previous slide, the weight of the classifier is calculated using the error of the classifier. After this, the weights of the data are updated. These are the weights of the data. Okay, alpha k is the weight of the classifier, wk is the weight of the data. Wk plus 1i is equal to wki exponential alpha k I hkx not equal to ti. So the weight of the data number I is updated based on this point, that if the classifier has an error on that data, the weight will be increased, and if it doesn't have an error, the weight will be decreased. Okay, so this formula is doing this. Okay, so here this is the new weight of the data, wk plus 1i, which is calculated using the error of classifier on that data. If it has error, the weight is increased. If it doesn't have error, the weight is decreased. Okay, so that's what we are doing in this iteration. We are building a classifier, finding the error of the classifier, based on that finding the weight of the classifier and the weight of the data. These are updated in each iteration. And then finally, the classifier will have this prediction. Okay, now we said in the previous slide that in boosting, the prediction is based on weighted majority vote. Okay, what does weighted majority vote mean? Okay, for example, here we have two outputs, minus 1 and plus 1. If I have 5 classifiers, okay, classifier 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I have 5 classifiers. Each of these classifiers, they have a weight, okay? For example, classifier 1, the weight is 0.1. Classifier 2 is 0.2, classifier 3 is 0.3, classifier 4 is 0.1, and classifier 5 is 0.2. Okay, now we have two classes, class 1 and class minus 1. If a data enters these 5 classifiers, and each of these classifiers have a prediction. For example, the classifier 1, the prediction is 1. Classifier 2, the prediction is minus 1. Classifier 3, the prediction is minus 1. Classifier 4, the prediction is 1. Classifier 5, the prediction is 1. Okay, so we have 5 classifiers, each of them has a weight. Each of them have a prediction. Now, what is the result of this prediction? What could we do? The weighted majority vote says we get the weight of each output. For example, the output 1, the output is 1 or minus 1. The weight of 1 is what? Is 0.1. Okay, we add the weight of the classifiers. Plus 0.1 plus 0.2. This is the weight of 1. And the weight of minus 1 is what? 0.2 plus 0.3. Okay, so it's equal to 0.5. And this is equal to 0.4. So we see that the weight of the output minus 1 is higher than plus 1. So the prediction, the final prediction would be minus 1. This is called weighted majority vote. Okay, this is about boosting. The next type of ensemble learning is stacking. In this type of combination, we have two layers of learning. Okay, this is a type of ensemble. Okay, we have two layers of learning. In the first layer, some classifiers are trained. But in the second layer, we are training based on the output of the classifiers. It means in the second layer, the data that is used for training is the output of the classifiers in the first layer. This is very important about this method. So we have a data here, an instance. This data comes into the model. Here we have some classifiers, M1, M2, MM. Each of these classifiers, they have an output. Okay, and based on this output, we have an error. Okay, then this here, this meta M, this is the second layer. This is the second layer. In this layer, we are training a classifier using this data. Okay, using this data. This is the data. What is this data? This data xj is the input, and these are the outputs of the classifier. So we are using the output of the classifier or the error of the classifier as a data for training this learning model here, which is the second layer. In the first layer, we are training the classifiers based on our data, and in the second layer, we are training them based on the output of the learning models. This is called a stacking. This is a special type of ensemble learning. And the last type of ensemble learning, it's called mixture of experts. Mixture of experts. In the mixture of experts, okay, we have some classifiers that the classifiers are different. As you see in the bagging and boosting, the classifiers were the same. All of them were one type of classifier. But in the mixture of expert, the classifiers are different. And each classifier has a weight, same as boosting. And the prediction method is weighted majority vote, the same as boosting. Okay, so this is the whole logic of this method, mixture of experts. So we have some classifiers, each of them have a weight, and then we are making the final prediction using the weighted majority vote. We are making the final prediction using the weighted majority vote. As you see here, this is classifier 1, D1, D2, DL. We have L classifiers. Each of these classifiers, they have a weight, W1, W2, WL. These are the weights of the vote of each classifier, and the final prediction is the weighted majority vote. When the data enters these classifiers, okay, these classifiers are trained on the training data, and the weights are defined based on the error of each classifier, same as the boosting. And in the test phase, when the data enters these classifiers, each of them will have a prediction, and the final prediction would be the weighted majority vote, similar to the boosting algorithm. Thank you very much.